And also at 5 now, some breaking news. First details of a shooting that involved Dayton police officers.
Just minutes ago, Dayton police chiefs answered questions about a robbery attempt that then turned violent. Megan O'Rourke begins our live breaking news.
Mark, Michelle, right now both Dayton police officers are involved, are on paid administrative leave, but officials here at headquarters are calling them heroes tonight for their brave actions trying to apprehend that robbery suspect.
A 17-year-old suspect is carted away on a stretcher moments after officials say he opened fire on an undercover Dayton police officer Wednesday night. Thursday afternoon, Dayton Police Chief Richard Beal held a news conference and explained the circumstances surrounding the crime. He says they were alerted by a Donato's Pizza employee who received an order from a phone number that had previously been associated with another armed robbery. Instead of sending the driver to complete the potentially dangerous delivery, Beal says an officer went undercover.
Officer Matt Heiser, dressed in plain clothes and driving an unmarked car, drove to the 1500 block of Superior Avenue to deliver the pizza.
Beal says the suspect came out between two homes, approached the officer, and then displayed a semi-automatic handgun. The officer identified himself, and that's when Beal says the bullets started flying. The suspect started shooting, and Officer Heiser and his backup, Officer Ron Gosweiler, returned fire. Neither officer was injured, but the suspect was shot.
Tell you definitively, there was three entrance wounds. They were all from the front. We can't get into a lot of the details of the surgery, but he did undergo surgery, has recovered. He is in stable condition. He is alert and conscious.
The teen is not charged, so his name is not being released at this time, but Beal says they plan to meet with prosecutors in the future. In the meantime, he says both officers are doing well and should be recognized for their service.
It speaks to their heroism. In fact, this is not uncommon. Dayton police officers, in fact, law enforcement officers throughout this region, every day put themselves between harm and individuals who would cause that harm. So they basically take these kind of actions very routinely to put themselves in the way before an individual who would commit harm against innocent persons. That's what we do.
Now, you may remember this is the second officer-involved shooting so far this year here in this city. The last one happened in June when officials say an 18-year-old suspect in a stolen car tried to run over a Dayton police officer. Reporting live, Megan O'Rourke, 2 News on your side.